Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Renault, optometrist at Eagle Eye Performance Vision, where we specialize in vision therapy, and today we'll be talking all about strabismus. And before we get started, make sure to hit the subscribe button on our channel. Find us on Facebook and Instagram as we post videos and content to help make vision therapy more visible. Okay, strabismus. You may be watching this video because your child was recently diagnosed with strabismus, or you've just noticed an eye turning or wandering around, or maybe you've been dealing with this problem your whole life and you're interested in finding a solution for it. So let me break it down for you. So strabismus is where one eye can point in the right spot and then the other eye drifts inward, outward, up or down. They're not pointing in the same spot in space. And we may call that lazy eye or an eye turn, or some people call it an eye squint. Really, either way, it's where one eye points in the right spot and one eye does not point in the right spot. There's different types of strabismus. We have exotropia, where one eye can point outward and then the other eye is straight. There's esotropia, where an eye points inward. There's hypertropia, where one eye points upward. And hypotropia, where one eye points downward. So this sounds like an eye problem, but I really want you to think of it as a brain-eye connection problem. This is a binocular vision dysfunction. And binocular vision is really incredible if you think about it. We have two eyes, two cameras really, on the front of our face that send an image to our brain, and our brain automatically and instinctively and simultaneously combines those two pictures into one. So it's a really incredible process to take two pictures and combine them into one. And in strabismus, that's a problem when we've got two eyes in two different spots. So the patient can see two different pictures. If I see you here and you over here, in the brain I'm getting double vision. Double vision is extremely disruptive to just about everything. Double vision is not a good thing, and for patients who have strabismus at a very young age, they can often create an adaptation where they turn off the information from one eye to create single vision. So that's called suppression. It's where we suppress the information from one eye and really walk around with just one eye working, and the other eye, the brain is completely ignoring it as much as possible, which is a good thing. We alleviate double vision. The patient can see single vision and function fairly well. The problems with suppression is it takes a lot of cognitive effort to do that, and it also eliminates depth perception. Depth perception is a binocular skill where we can tell exactly how far away things are. How far is that car in front of you as you're driving, or that baseball you're trying to catch? Or how far should I focus my eyes while reading? There's all kinds of functional visual tasks that we go through in life, like mobility and coordination, that require good depth perception for us to function and thrive. And really, the risk factor for when it's one eye that's always turned, that can also create another condition called amblyopia, where that eye that's always turned, that eye is really, and it's really not used, it's probably suppressed and ignored by the brain. That eye doesn't really develop very well, and it's not quite able to see 20/20, nice clear vision, even with glasses or contacts. If a patient always has one eye that's drifting and pointing in the wrong spot and it's never really used correctly, that eye, not only does it not point in the right spot, but it may not see as clearly as the eye that's more accurate and used more frequently. So now, this is obviously a big problem for visual function. What are the treatment options? One of them, probably the more common one, is to do strabismus surgery. The goal is to create cosmetically straight eyes. When we look at that patient, now their eyes look straight. So the surgeon will actually cut and move the eye muscles into a posture that's straighter, more aligned with the other eye. And that is it's a good thing for cosmetic purposes. Some other pros are it's very quick. It's really the same day. There's not a lot of work on the patient's part. They can have relatively straight eyes in best case scenario within that same day of treatment. So those are some good things about strabismus surgery. Some concerns and risk factors we have to watch out for are, you know, we're really treating the wrong spot. And I don't want you to think of strabismus as an eye problem. It's more of a brain controlling the eyes problem. And in lots of cases, not always, but lots of cases, the eye muscles, they work perfectly fine. They are just not calibrated quite the same and used the same way in the brain. So strabismus surgery is more of an anatomical fix, but not a physiological fix. It doesn't teach the brain how to use both eyes together. And another problem with strabismus surgery is it's a very hard surgery to get just right. So we have such a small margin for error with those tiny eye muscles that lots of times patients need to come in for a second or third or fourth round of surgery trying to fix how the first surgery went. After surgery, the eye could drift in other directions again. So that's why they may need a second round of surgery. Another problem with that is each surgery requires anesthesia. So anyone under 2 years of age, there's a really higher risk for learning disabilities with repeated exposure to anesthesia. So there are risk factors that parents should be aware of, and then they can make a comfortable and confident decision when they have all the right information. Another way to approach strabismus, another great treatment, is vision therapy. And we recommend vision therapy as an alternative or in tandem with surgery. You should do vision therapy before and after surgery to try to train those two eyes to work together in the brain. Train that brain to control two eyes that are going to be in totally different spots now than they were prior to surgery. So while strabismus surgery is more of an eye muscle treatment, you can think of vision therapy as a brain-eye connection treatment. So what does vision therapy look like? Really, our goal goes beyond just getting those cosmetically straight eyes. Yes, we want the eyes to be aligned at any distance where they can point to the same spot in space together. We also want to develop binocular vision where the patient can break down that suppression. They can learn to use two eyes and not just one eye. Once they do that, they can also develop fine detail visual acuity, try to see as close to equal as possible. If that other eye can't see 20/20 yet, try to get it to see 20/20. We also go even beyond just seeing clear in 3D, but teach those two eyes to work together. So think of the task of reading, something we all do every single day. To read, we need to point both eyes inward together, focus both eyes up onto the page together, move across the page, word to word to word, line after line after line, two eyes together as a team. If we only have one eye working and the other eye is really bringing up the slack and not participating in that task, then all kinds of problems like poor performance and headaches can take place. Sports can be difficult if your eyes don't move at the same rate. Driving, if you have constricted peripheral vision, then you're not seeing the whole space on the road, and that's a safety hazard. So these are goals that we shoot for in vision therapy that go way beyond just seeing 20/20 with straight eyes. So vision therapy can be accomplished in a lot of different ways. There's a lot of philosophies and in optometry on how to treat these patients. In our office, we typically see patients once or twice a week for about an hour at a time, and then send them home with activities to reinforce what they did in the office, to continuously train that brain. Hey, this is how you use two eyes together. Let's use this and apply it to your real world. And in our practice, we use real space vision therapy and virtual world vision therapy. So we partner with Vivid Vision, who is a company that they use virtual reality technology, think the virtual reality goggles. And in there, we can actually change what the left and the right eye sees to try to create an equal environment where both eyes can see equally. So we're able to break down suppression. We can move targets over to where that deviated turned eye is to try to lower that eye turn and get it closer to straight. And even also develop depth perception and binocular visual skills too within that system. Everything we do in our life has some kind of visual demand that we try to develop and improve in the therapy room and then translate it to their real life. So you may be wondering, when's the right time to do vision therapy? When's the right time to treat strabismus? And there's a wonderful concept that's backed up in all kinds of research called neuroplasticity, which means the brain is able to learn and develop new pathways at any age, really. So our brain is very resilient and eager to learn, eager to do things more efficiently and functionally. So at any age, if we expose the brain to, hey, this is how you use two eyes, and see how much more comfortable it is, see how much better 3D depth perception looks, the brain loves that and it's able to learn and develop and change the way it uses those eyes. And that can happen as young as an infant or toddler all the way to adulthood. So anyone who's thinking about addressing their strabismus, this is an option for them. So to get started, if you're in West Michigan, definitely check out our website, eagleeyevisiontherapy.com, or give us a call at 616-848-7548 to get the conversation started, get the ball rolling, and see if this is something that you would benefit from. If you're outside of our area watching this and you want to find a vision therapy optometrist nearby, check out covd.org, click locate a doctor, and then you'll be able to find someone close by who can help you out and start resolving and improving that strabismus, that eye turn that's so detrimental. So thank you so much for watching. Hopefully this was helpful for you, and stay tuned for more content and videos.